Thanks for joining us. This fast-paced video will show you how to create a solar-powered APRS weather station. First, we start off with a 30-foot telescoping mast with guy wire supports. Now let's unpack and install our solar panel mount kit. Instructions on how to do this are included with the kit. In this example, we're using a 75-watt solar panel, but your installation site might require a higher wattage panel, or do just fine with a lower wattage panel. At this point, we need to cut two small pieces of SuperStrut to attach the solar panel to the telescoping mast. Using the two pieces of SuperStrut we just cut, slide one cone nut into the center position of each of the two pieces. Now we can unpack the SuperStrut pipe strap. This will hold the SuperStrut to the telescoping mast. It's time to start attaching the solar panel hardware to the mast. Start by loosely securing both SuperStrut pipe straps around the mast. Before we tighten the pipe straps, we need to ensure proper spacing by attaching the solar panel hinge mount to the cone nuts with hex bolts. Now we can tighten the straps to the mast. At this point, we're ready to attach the solar panel to the mast using the hardware supplied in the mount kit. For this installation, we're using a Comet GP1 2-meter band antenna. Go ahead and assemble the antenna using the supplied instructions. Now we can go ahead and attach the antenna to the top of the mast. Be sure to attach a cable to your antenna. I find an RG213 is sufficient. Don't use a cable with low amounts of shielding such as an RG58. The radiation leakage during transmit can cause problems with the weather station. While we're here, let's install the anemometer that comes with the Davis Vantage Pro 2 weather station using the supplied U-bolt. Now that we're done with the top of the mast, let's raise it to full height. While raising the mast, you may want to apply some UV-resistant zip ties to hold the antenna coax and the anemometer cable firmly in place. Normally there'd be two or three sets of guy wires for this type of mast, but since this is for demonstration purposes only, we will only have the bottom set of guy wires. With the mast fully raised, we can now install the rest of the weather station sensors. All hardware and instructions on how to do this are included with the Vantage Pro 2. Be sure to plug in the anemometer and secure any excess cable you may have. It's time to start building our electronics boxes. Let's start by preparing the TNC for mounting by removing the circuit card from inside its enclosure. Use a marker to indicate the area where we can install the mounting screws. Now let's drill a couple of holes for those mounting screws to go in. Now we can position our TNC enclosure on the sidewall of our electronics box and mark where we want to drill our screw holes. With all the TNC mounting holes drilled, we can put the TNC back together, leaving the cover off. Using screws and bolts, secure the TNC to the sidewall of the electronics box and replace the TNC cover. Check to be sure that you've left enough room to press the power button on the TNC. Now let's solder the power wires onto the supplied connector. Instructions on how to do this are included with the TNC. Now we're ready to mount the transceiver to the electronics box. We'll mount it to the sidewall, opposite of the TNC, using the supplied dash mount kit. The Weatherlink APRS data logger will enable us to take the information from the weather console and push it into the TNC. While we're in the console, we'll go ahead and add the 3C cell batteries before closing it up. Using a second electronics box, we can add a couple of mounting screws to hang our weather console. These are two screws each with two nuts, one on the inside of the box and one on the outside. This will allow us to set the screw head back enough to hang the console. In the same box as the weather console, we'll mount the charge controller on the left upper wall. The charge controller will make sure the solar panel doesn't overcharge the batteries.
Okay. I believe there's, I counted.
In order to connect the two boxes together, we'll be joining them with a piece of flexible conduit. In this case, we don't need a full 12 inches of conduit, so we'll be cutting it in half. Using a multi-step drill bit, drill the holes in the boxes and join them together using the flex conduit. Now that that's complete, let's secure the two electronics boxes together with a piece of SuperStrut on the top and bottom backs of the boxes. This will be used to mount the boxes to the mast later on. Here you can see I'm marking the spots where to drill the bolt holes. Now slide the cone nuts into the SuperStrut over each of the holes that you've drilled. With the holes drilled and the cone nuts in place, you can now attach the SuperStrut to the boxes with some bolts and washers. With the SuperStrut in place, we can connect the TNC to radio cable, allowing the two devices to talk to each other. Now it's time to connect the power wires. We'll start by reducing the length of the radio power cable and connecting it to the radio. Then we'll connect the TNC power cable that we soldered together earlier. Once those two cables are connected, we'll wire nut them together with a third set of wires, which will connect to the batteries.
If I do that, I'll lose all my stuff I've done since then. Everything is thrown away from that date forward.
At this point, we can crimp on our battery connectors, being sure to add another set of wires under those connectors to allow us to parallel daisy chain to the next battery. This whole system uses about half an amp power draw. We have a total of 40 amp hours battery capacity, giving us an operating duration of 80 hours in total darkness. Your system may be sized differently depending upon your location. Once you've added sufficient battery capacity for your system, connect the last battery to the charge controller. Connect the weather console to a serial port on your computer using the Weatherlink supplied cables and adapters. Load the Weatherlink software and check your settings. You'll need to enter a GPS location and a transmit duration. Be sure the duration is set to 5 minutes or greater. To program the TNC, you'll need a DB25 male to DB9 female cable. Once connected, program your TNC using the following commands. Be sure to substitute the call sign with your own. Now we can attach the Weatherlink supplied DB25 to RJ11 blue TNC adapter and connect the included cable. After feeding the cable through the flex conduit, connect the other end to the Weather Console APRS data logger. At this point, we can pre-drill a hole for the antenna cable to feed through. Since we've completed the electronics boxes, it's time to fasten them to the mast using the SuperStrut pipe straps. Now let's connect our antenna cable to the back of the radio. Before we connect the solar panel wires, drill a hole in the bottom of the box to fish them through. Then connect them to the charge controller. If we don't want to be replacing the 3C cell batteries in the weather console every couple of months, we'll need to build a 5-volt DC power supply to feed it. The console comes with an AC to DC power supply, which won't work in this kind of remote situation. For this setup, we're going to modify a 12-volt USB car charger to power the console, since all USB ports output 5 volts DC, just like the console needs. We can take a spare USB cable and cut it. Separate out the red and black power wires. These will be your 5-volt DC power wires for your console. Now we can cut the supplied AC power cord adapter off and connect it to the USB power wires.
Yours anyway.
Connect the 12-volt leads to the charge controller, battery terminals, and the USB cord to your weather console. You can now put the electronics box covers on. With the system now complete, I hope you found this informative, and thanks for watching.